Hey guys, you're watching Desi Martini and my name is Zinia Bandopadhyay. Today we have with us the man who's going to portray none other than the imposing, the ferocious and the deadly Roger Binney on screen with 83. Yes, I'm talking about Nishant Dahiya. Hi Nishant, welcome to Desi Martini.
Thank you so much, Zinia. Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you so much for having me here.
Pleasure is all ours, by the way. But to play a man like Roger Binney, who had taken the most number of wickets during the 83 World Cup, if I'm not mistaken, it must have been like a different level of challenge, isn't it?
It's always a big challenge to do a biopic and to portray a living legend. And it was a huge challenge, in fact, but it was a challenge that I was really excited about to take up. And while playing also Roger Sir's part, I think the most important part was the preparation for it, because to play a living legend like Roger Sir himself and to emulate someone, to copy how he did, how he bowled, how he walked, how he talked. I think that was my biggest challenge, and also to look like him, to try to kind of match the physicality of how he looked. And that was also a challenge. Biggest challenge was also to copy Roger Sir's action, because he has a very unorthodox action. Mm-hmm. Like he used to pull with a very unorthodox action. And also because he used to be a javelin thrower during his early years. He used to throw the javelin. Yeah. Not many people know about that, Roger Sir. Roger Sir was a fantastic javelin thrower. So he had his body had the natural inclination to basically bend in a certain way that how javelin throwers do in the end. That's what, when he's bowling also, that's how his action became. So if you match like a javelin thrower's action while putting their first foot down when they're about to throw the javelin, it's so similar to Roger Sir's bowling action. So that was the most difficult, I think that was the most challenging part for me to do, to get that. That was the most challenging. It took me around 6 months. In fact, I don't even know whether I did it 100%, because it was really, really difficult to get. So, but I know that throughout the shooting of the film, every day in the evening, I was still working on it. I was still working on how to somehow completely like mirror Roger Sir's bowling action. That was the most difficult part. I underwent a lot of injuries, a lot of pain. Injections, tablets, just to try and bend my body a certain way, how Roger Sir used to do. So,
how did you cope up with all that, with the injections, the tablets, everything, and then practicing all the time?
I mean, I was the pain honestly wasn't much of a hindrance, because there was too much of a motivation to play this part. And I was just being so happy being a part of this historic film. So the pain could never stop me. I mean, for me as a person, I've always been a sports person. So I've always had injuries since childhood. So injuries were never an issue in my life earlier as well. So it was again a part, because we were doing a sports film, there were bound to be injuries. A lot of people were injured during the shoot at some point or the other. So it was always something that we had all thought of, prepared of mentally also, that we would definitely be injured while doing something like this, while trying to change our body in a certain way that it has never moved. You know, so suddenly you have to change everything about your body mechanics to copy someone. So you'll have niggles here, there, every second day you'll feel something. Oh, how did, I'm feeling something here, I'm feeling something here. So that was also, but that's also like such an exciting part of it, trying to do something different that you haven't done, which just keeps your creative juices flowing, keeps you happy in the head. So there's nothing that I can say that I haven't enjoyed. The whole process has been so enriching of trying to play a living legend like Roger Sir on screen, trying to bring it to life. And also now when the film is very near to its release, I'm just kind of nervous about, not about the audience's reactions as such, but more about Roger Sir's reaction when he watches the film and how he thinks, whether I have been able to somehow, to some extent, captured his being as to the soul of Roger Binney in that film. Let's see. It's still up to test, and this will only be I'll only be happy if Roger Binney sir comes back and gives me a pat on my back. I think that would be like the it moment for me. I'll be done. I'll be happy.
That would be the biggest award, I think. But I'm pretty sure with the amount of hard work that you have put, with the amount of research everyone in the team has done, I'm pretty sure this film is going to be epic as the 83 winning moment had been.
I mean, we are all World Cup winners in our own right now. We all can boast that we have won the World Cup.
Yeah, because you also had a camp in Dharamshala, if I'm not wrong. That was, I think, for 10 months that went on, and you guys had to practice thoroughly during that time, bond as cricketers in a green room would bond, right?
I think that was more about, that camp was more about for our bonding, so that we'll always be together, we'll be training, we'll be going by the bus, coming by the bus.
Yeah.
And I think we all bonded. We were already bonding so well while we were just practicing in Bombay also. But going to Dharamshala was an experience because everything changed. We were all there, away from all the tensions in Bombay, away from all the work thing and all the people. We were just together like a team. How a team would travel and they'll play their matches for 24 hours, right? So that also gave us a chance to be mentally, to be with everyone and to bond. And I think that really helped. And that really shows in the film also. Once you watch the film, I think you'll see the bond that we all share as a team. And off camera, I think we all have had such a wonderful bond. There have never been any sort of indifferences or any sort of problems that we have ever had, which rarely happens wherever there are so many people involved, whether it's a film or it's, for that matter, whether it's a company also or whatever sort of environment, where there's so many people who are there together for nearly a year, there are bound to be some differences. But strangely, this film, this team really lived like a team. So there were hardly any differences, even if someone wanted to get some bite of a difference or something, but there were none. Strangely, I when I was going for the film, when I was starting, I felt okay, there would be some differences with someone, but to my surprise and to my happiness, it never happened, which was so wonderful. That's one of the unique, also one of the unique things about this film, that everyone was has been such a sport and such a I can say such an influence on me, such an inspiration, that I've learned something from someone in this, on this film, like from everyone. Like I've learned something from everyone on this film. They've all been great in their own regard, in something or the other. But it has been an enriching and such a lovely experience shooting for this. And I don't think I can ever forget. This film will always be my number one. Or whatever I do in my life now, from now onwards, this will always be number one. Number two will come after this now.
Also, when you know there's so many people, and if the bond is great, if your guys are like vibing on the same wavelength, we can already understand what kind of feelings you must have had while shooting for it. We are getting a glimpse of the strong bond with all the teasers, trailers, the promos that are coming out, of course. But, you know, this is also, so there was, I think, one known person in the group that you have worked before. There was Saqib Saleem, who you have shared screen with before. So I think that should have made it a little easier. Or was it like you went and the ice broke pretty naturally?
I think with Saqib, before I joined the project, Saqib had already was already on the project, and when I obviously, that was the first thing on my mind, that okay, Saqib is there, and Saqib and me have We have a very strong bond. We met a year or two before we did Friendship. So we knew each other before we worked on Friendship. That was not the first time that we met on Friendship. So we had worked before also. And we hit it off the first time we met, me and Saqib. And till now also, we were hanging out yesterday only.
Oh, wow.
So he's like... we are like, how it is such a common phrase, brother from another mother. He's that for me. We hang out a lot off set also, and on set also. He was always my go-to guy, because from Friendship days, now it's been around 12 years that me and Saqib know each other, and we have been really through all these years. Having Saqib on the set, having him there on the first day when I went for the trainings as well, because there were people already training before I joined the film. Ooh. So one of the factors that made it a little easier, definitely, to just know, okay, there's someone that I know, and I went there. But obviously, we met like how we meet, but it was, to my surprise, it was very easy to mingle with others also. Ooh. Everyone... with open arms, and honestly, I didn't even feel like it was my first day of training. When I finished the day, it was like, okay, I know everyone like that. We would have our training sessions, we would go out, we would go walk to the corner wala chai wala guy, we would all have tea there. Every day, that was our routine. In Juhu, right next to PVR, we used to train, and every day we used to walk to the chai wala guy, have chai and everything, and talk about the training sessions, talk about life, and be there for half an hour, and then leave for our places.
This completely sounds like how a real camp would be like how even in college we would go, you know, to the tapri wala nearby and have some chai, coffee. It's exactly like that.
Yeah, it was just we are still college going people. We are still normal people. We also do that everyone does. We are no different, right? So we also used to have chai and go there, probably have ban maska, you know. So all be hungry by then. We would all looking what can we eat. So someone's having biscuit, someone's having ban maska. So that was like a routine every day.
You know, Nishant, you have made your debut. It has been quite a few years since you have made your debut, and you have come on screen, but quite. There had been gaps also. Do you feel that that's also because of a lack of great projects that come up to you, or is it very difficult as an outsider to survive in Bollywood?
I think for me, the biggest reason for me doing less projects or less film has obviously got to do with something that I believe in, that I always believe in, quality then quantity. There are a lot of projects that are offered to me, but most of them I have kind of stayed away from. So when I started out in this industry, obviously I started out with the Yash Raj film, and that's like a dream project for anyone coming into this industry. And post that, there were some problems other than the acting part of it. I was away from the industry for nearly 3 years. Then I got back again and started doing my work. But also during that period, I had decided that I am only going to take up projects which kind of fuel me from inside, which kind of get that creative juice flowing. So that I had already spoken to myself about it, and that's how I function till now. So something, whatever thing comes up, until unless it just makes me feel that I want to do this, then only I pick it up. Otherwise, I generally kind of stay away from it because I think I have plenty of time. This is the learning phase of my career, of my life. And whatever I want to do, I want to be proud of. I don't want to look at something and say, okay, why did I do that? Why did I pick this thing? No, I should not have done that. So everything that I pick up, I always think about it. I give myself, I don't make decisions hastily. I always think, I always ponder about it. Then only I get back and think whether I'll go on and look back at it and proudly say I was associated with this project. So the length of the role doesn't matter, but the project and the thing that I'm doing it definitely matters for me a lot. I think that's also one of the primary, that's basically the primary reason for me doing such less projects Yes.
Okay. But also in a in an industry like Bollywood, which is so volatile, where there are several people trying to break in, where there are people, new people coming in every day. Do you not feel this fear of people not coming to you maybe one day, or getting out of relevance, or people not offering you anything someday? So how do you balance that thought that probably people won't come to me with when you say no to a project, or when you take up less projects?
I've always been a very secure individual. I've always been very secure individual since childhood. So whenever I'm doing something, or whether I'm in this industry, what others are doing, I hardly think about it. I mean, because I always believe we all have our own journeys. We all have our own struggles. We all have our highs, lows. So if someone is doing really well in their career, it never affects me. Or if someone is doing badly in their career, obviously I would think that this person should be doing better or something. But if someone is doing well or whatever, I have never compared my journey with anyone. That way, I never compare someone else doing something and thinking, oh, this person will take my part. Because I know I am me. If something is written for me, if something is meant for me, that will definitely come down back to me. It's never going anywhere. I've always been secure like that. So this doesn't worry me whether there are people coming, because competition is everywhere. It's just not this industry. Whenever we go, I'm an engineer. So when I was giving IIM exams, I know how much competition is there. When people are trying to be an IPS, IAS, or whatever, be a doctor these days, everywhere, whether it's a peon also, like competition, we can't escape competition. So this industry also has its share of competition. But competition should never ever scare you. It should only fuel you to do better, motivate you. That's what it does to me. I don't feel scared of it. I just feel, it's just a part of our lives. It's very normal.
Wow, that's such a positive outlook. Also, that's my takeaway from this interview. I'm going to take that into my life as well and try and be more secure. But thank you so much, Nishan. That would be the last question. I would have asked you more, but we would be short on time. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining with us, and good luck for 83.
Thank you so much, Zinia. It was a pleasure speaking to you.
The pleasure was all mine. Again, the pleasure was all mine.